know, yeah, I don't know. I can do it. Can't do it. But that brings us to Shoulda, Woulda, Coulda. Time to break down some of the league's top stories, the headlines ahead of the weekend. And I want to start with a guy who loves an ice cream sundae.
Yes, he does.
Ram safety Eric Weddle. He's taking on his former team, the Ravens, on Monday Night Football. I cannot wait for this game. And he was asked if he would share inside information about Baltimore, what goes on, how it works. And he said, quote, ESPN, I could tell them a lot of stuff, but that's not who I am, end quote. Should Eric Weddle share secrets about the Ravens, Nate?
Should he? Yes. Will he? Yes.
Art of War?
Of course. Listen, I get what he's saying, right? You don't want to tell the media that you're telling everybody secrets. Of course, then your former team is going to know that. But every player, when they go to a new team, because of, one, loyalty to who's cutting you a check, trying to win the game, you're going to tell the offense, the defense, the coordinators, head coach, whatever it is they need to know about your former squad. So, yes, he is going to, regardless of what he says, he is going to tell all of the secrets.
So why doesn't he just tell the truth if it's not frowned upon, if there's no, you know, integrity of the game issue at play?
Because you don't show your hand, okay? You never show your hand when you're gambling.
Eric Weddle's never been to a Super Bowl. Eric Weddle, this is the best chance he might have. This is the team. You got to give everything. You got to lay it out on the table. Here's not only their playbook, but here's what I've heard from this conversation. Here's what this guy likes. I look to Big Willie Anderson. You guys know who Big Willie Anderson is? Played for the Bengals for 10 years.
Freaky Dub.
Freaky Dub. Great offensive lineman. When he went to the Ravens after 10 years after being cut by the Bengals, I gave them two blitzes that I knew would destroy the Bengals' pass protections, and I told them in the dinner line what techniques he used as the weakest player. The entire D-line was standing there holding their trays. That's what you do. You give the entire, hey, you want the Manhattan Project? Here it is and more. Like, that's what it is. Give it all away. You're on our team now. Weddle, come on.
Do they ask for it or do they just offer it?
You got to proactively say, hey, coach.
I got the answers.
I got everything.
Cheat codes.
Brain drain, they call it.
You want to stop Lamar? Here's what you do.
I've seen lesser named players come onto a team midway through the season and get locked in a room and interrogated.
The lights all over.
Yes, because we were facing their former team. So, of course, Eric Weddle, he's not going to get interrogated.
I can't imagine not doing it. Nate, let's just say when you leave the show for a huge paycheck to a competing show and they sit you down, you're not going to spill all the secrets. You're not going to tell them, here's Kay's laptop password. Kyle's on uppers and I'm on downers, and that's the secret between them. You're going to spill it all, baby, and so should Weddle.
Take away Peter's coffee. It's a wrap.
He's done. It's a wrap off.
Kyle talks to himself all show long. I got you. All the secrets.
Not only do I think he will, Kay, I think Weddle's got the good intel. He's not like some down lineman. He knows the whole deal. So, yes, I do.
Don't you feel like Sean McVay's like so integrity driven that even though it's not a bad thing if he does it, I really do. I feel like isn't he one of those purists that like?
I think McVay was a head coach at like 25 years old and he got to slit some throats to get there.
So
yes, I do.
McVay is still playing video games using cheat codes, right?
Yeah. Well, we heard Jerry Jones say it makes no sense not to feed Zeke Elliott the ball. Hello, I agree. And he was asked, of course, about Zeke's diminished role in this offense this season. Zeke said that's what a good teammate does. So if you were the Cowboys coaching staff, Kyle, on Sunday, would you force the ball to Zeke Elliott against the Patriots?
Here's the curveball. I don't think that they're going to have to. I'm going to go Jim Cantore on you. Forecast for Sunday is rain, wet, mud. It is going to be a mess if it holds up, and that is a Zeke special. I think that the Zeke running game cannot hold a candle to the Dak passing game, and it's hard to hold a candle in the cold November rain. So I think they're going to go Zeke all day. I would.
That was pretty good, guys.
That was pretty good.
I'm going to say, no, they shouldn't force the ball to him, but I do believe there will be a heavy dose of scripted plays to Zeke in the first 15 plays.
Wasn't that forcing it? Like Ben saying, like basically prescribing it?
That contradicts exactly what I'm saying. Yes, they're going to force the ball to him in the first 15 plays, and then after that, they're going to decide how the defense is going to play him. Yeah. But I do believe this is going to be Kellen's most creative game plan.
Yeah.
So if you're at home and you want something to watch, go get you some popcorn, sit back, and see how Kellen Moore and the Cowboys offense script their first 15 plays. If it is creative, they have a chance of winning. If it's not, they get punched in the mouth, they're 4-0, it's a wrap for
the
Cowboys.
Perfect. Make it situational, though. Don't go in there thinking, okay, we're going to give him the ball this many times, because we saw the Cowboys lose a game when he was having an ineffective day, rushing like 2-something yards per carry, and then they gave him to him at the end when they should have thrown the ball. So you have to think situationally, because the Patriots do that.
Absolutely. And, you know, we always hear Belichick takes away your best weapon. He'll make it. Leighton Vander Esch might not be going in this game now, is the latest we've heard. He might be their best defensive player. Like, this one's up against it. And to Kyle's point, the rain will play a huge deal. I have no GNR lyrics, but I will say this. This is not a great situation going into Foxborough in a late window game in the pouring rain for Dak Prescott and this Cowboys team that doesn't play a lot of games that way.
No lyrics? No lyrics. Don't cry.
Do you need some time on your own?
Have some patience.
Just a little bit, okay.
Do you need some time all alone?
No, I'm for the group.
Great song. I'm for the